Good day, I'm Stacey Ann Smith, and this is your GIS News for Tuesday, November 4. As part of Jamaica's response to Ebola, the country is participating in an emergency risk communication training workshop now underway in Barbados. Representatives from participating countries are learning how to better communicate health risks and empower citizens in keeping with international health regulations. More than 100 delegates from 30 countries across the region have gathered for the three-day workshop, which got underway on Tuesday. The workshop, which was organized by the Pan American Health Organization, PAHO, in partnership with the World Health Organization, WHO, will focus on illnesses like chikungunya, dengue, and Ebola. PAHO's director, Dr. Carissa Etienne, addressed participants at the opening ceremony.
PAHO WHO is committed to bolstering all of the required skills in the countries to respond to a possible introductory case of Ebola in Latin America and the Caribbean and to contain it. Upon request, we will send in-country missions.
In the meantime, Jamaica is also being represented by the country's High Commissioner, Ambassador Sharon Saunders, at the 17th special meeting of the Conference of Heads of Government. The meeting, which is being held in Trinidad and Tobago, will focus on the threat of Ebola as well as the Caribbean's response to chikungunya. Meanwhile, the Ministry of Health is assuring members of the public that Jamaica's contact tracing system is well-equipped to locate and isolate individuals who may have been exposed to Ebola. Acting Permanent Secretary in the Ministry, Dr. Kevin Harvey, says public health professionals have been trained to effectively conduct contact tracing. He says the Ministry's contact tracing system has been used effectively over the years to identify suspected cases of HIV, tuberculosis, measles, and malaria.
For Ebola, the additional step would be that we would be required to quarantine those persons who were in contact with somebody who had Ebola and to ensure that those persons remain within the quarantine space. And for that, we would require, and we will have support from the police and the JDF.
Dr. Harvey was one of several guests outlining government's preparedness for the Ebola virus on a recently televised panel discussion. The program was an initiative of the Office of the Prime Minister. And members of parliament have joined the national emergency response to the chikungunya outbreak by carrying out cleanup activities in their constituencies. The latest initiative took place over the weekend in West St. Andrew, where Member of Parliament Anthony Hilton, along with residents, removed debris from a number of communities, including Seaview and Coraville Gardens. A cleanup exercise is also scheduled this week in Waterhouse St. Andrew.
We intend to, out of the adversity of chikungunya, bring to the public at large and a level of awareness about their role as well as to how they can contribute in their community to improve the conditions and to mitigate the risks to them and the community.
In the meantime, the National Health Emergency Vector Control Cleanup Team, led by Colonel Daniel Price, destroyed mosquito breeding sites in Western Kingston last week. The team removed 19 loads of solid waste from sections of Tivoli Gardens to Marcus Garvey Drive. Plans are also in place for activities to continue this week in Denham Town and Hannatown. Government has begun the process of merging the Jamaica Racing Commission, JRC, and the Betting, Gaming and Lotteries Commission, the BGLC. Finance Minister Dr. Peter Phillips told Parliament last Tuesday that under the first phase of the merger, the administrative operations of both companies were being combined. The merger will help to create a properly funded regulatory authority for the gaming and horse racing sectors.
There is some legislative amendment that is necessary to effect the complete merger of the two entities, and I expect that to be concluded shortly. But they are going to move operations into a single location. They're going to share the critical administrative staff, and that is underway now.
In the meantime, Dr. Phillips also told Parliament that the enterprise team overseeing the divestment of Caymanas Track Limited has already completed its analysis of the entity. And finally, the Minister of Education, Reverend Ronald Thwaites, is encouraging communities to be more active in the upbringing of the nation's children, especially those at the early childhood level.
When we take our emphasis into the school system to encourage family life and parenting, may I suggest that we pay particular emphasis as a starting point at our parent places, at wherever we are, with the early childhood cohort. My own experience, however anecdotal, is that it is at that stage that parents seem to take a particular incipient interest in their child's future.
Minister Thwaites was speaking on Friday at the launch of Parents Month, which is being commemorated under the theme Building Circles of Involvement, Home, School and Community. The minister also announced that during November, the Education Ministry will roll out the Valuable Pathways program, which involves the integration of positive values and attitudes into the school curriculum. And that's it for GIS News Today. I'm Stacey Ann Smith. Thank you for watching.